Hello everyone, it is I, everyone's favorite jack of all trades with the foul mouth, Commodore Irvin. And before I begin with this very special video, I just want to give a shout out to all of my subscribers, both new and old. Thank you for tuning in and watching my videos on the channel, and thank you for subscribing to the Commodore's crew. I appreciate it. Every subscriber helped, and every view for these videos help. Gets the word of all the fucking shit I'm doing out to everybody, because I don't do this for my own fucking health. I do this shit for you guys. So without any further ado, this is a very special video, guys, because this is a tribute to one of my favorite authors, the late, great John Maxtone-Graham. Now, there's a little story. Well, I'll tell you here in a little bit, but the reason why I'm doing this video is because I just recently acquired an item that I bought. Like, I bought it Tuesday. This particular item I bought Tuesday night, and this is Friday. And I got it today, on a Friday. I ordered it a Tuesday and got it a Friday. And that quick. And it came all the way from fucking California. So, yeah, it's fucking crazy. But I'll tell you guys a little bit about Mr. Maxtone-Graham. I want to show you some of the books that I own. I'll show you the special thing that I got. And then we'll go from there. So, Mr. John Maxtone-Graham, he was born August the 2nd of 1929 in Orange, New York, to a Scottish father and an American mother. He's Scottish-American. He had served in the United States Marine Corps during the Korean War. He was a very successful Broadway stage manager, and in 1972 he broke out into the literary scene with his massive successive book, The Only Way to Cross, The History of the Transatlantic Ocean Liner. And he wrote a long, long, long string of amazing books, including France/Norway in 2010, The Centennial Review of the Titanic, Titanic Tragedy in 2012, and sadly his last book, SS United States, Red, White, and Blue Ribbon Forever, was published October of 2014. He was married twice. His first wife was Katrina Maxtone-Graham, and his second wife was Mary Maxtone-Graham, and he had four children. And his oldest son is Ian Maxtone-Graham. He was the producer of the animated sitcom series The Simpsons, which John Maxtone-Graham was a guest star on an episode. And sadly, in July the 6th of 2015, at the age of 86, Mr. Maxtone-Graham had peacefully passed away in his Manhattan flat from respiratory failure. Yeah, it was sad. I cried forever. I cried for hours because of it when I found out. But I'm going to show you guys my collection of books, my special surprise I got show you guys. And I'll just tell you guys a little bit, and then there we go. The first book that I got here to show you, I just reviewed this book not too long ago, Liners to the Sun. This was the second book of the Trilogy of Sea Travel series, because the first is The Only Way to Cross, the third, Crossing and Cruising. This is the second book of the two. This one was published by Macmillan. This is Crossing and Cruising, the third of the trilogy. It was published by Scribers, which was a division of Macmillan. And I'm reading it right now. There will be a fucking review of it coming soon. And then this one here, Titanic Survivor, by Violet Jessop. He introduced, edited, and annotated it. And this book landed him on the bestsellers list. And here's actually a picture of the legend himself in his younger years. And of course, you know, I got two versions of this next book. Queen Mary II, The Greatest Ocean Liner of Our Time, This version is the inaugural edition, which is a big, massive hardback book. This is like a $150, $200 book. It's a collector's piece. This is for when the ship was inaugurated. The maiden voyage edition of the book was released by Bullfinch Press. The collector's edition was published. I'm trying to think. The collector's edition was published by Carpe Diem Books. This one was published by Bullfinch. And this one actually was purchased on board the Queen Mary II. Of course, here's a picture of the author, of course, later on in life, but still as quick and as sharp-witted. And sadly, this was the final book he ever got to wrote, SS United States. And this was actually this book. And here's a picture of the author in much later years. This was actually a book that I was going to send to him to autograph, because in all of his books he puts his address in them, you know, so he could mail checks and stuff for, like, you know, for different things he was selling. I was going to send this book to him and a bunch of drawings and stuff of the Normandy that I drew for him, because he was smitten over the Normandy. And I even had a marker in this book where I wanted him to sign it. If I could find it again. Motherfucker. Right here. I want him signed up in his upper corner, because I thought it would be awesome right there. And of course, like a day or so before I was getting ready to send the package, my sister came over, and she was like, who's that guy you always talk about, the author? I'm like, you mean John Maxtone-Graham? She's like, yeah. I was like, yeah, I was getting ready to send this to him because I wanted him to autograph a book for me. And she said, well, you may not want to do that. I'm like, why? She's like, he died. I'm like, what? And she let me read her phone and saw his obituary, respiratory failure, and I couldn't help it. I cried forever. I wanted to meet him. I wanted to meet the man so badly, because his books was what made me interested in ocean liners. You know, the movie Titanic was the bridge. His book, The Only Way to Cross, was the gate that opened up to my love for ocean liners, including the almighty SS United States. They call her M'lady. But that goes back to, you know, what I bought online. I was trying to buy some stuff from the SS United States for my collection. Sadly, one of the items I was trying to buy, I thought I had bought it, but it was a fucking bid, and I was outbidded, and I was pissed as hell. So I regrouped, and I thought, well, I'll look for something else. So I typed in John Maxtone-Graham books, and this book popped up, and it was perfect. And I paid $20 for it, and it came from California. And the book I bought was The Only Way to Cross. You're probably wondering, why did you buy this? Well, because this is the first book he ever wrote, and it's the best book. And this is not the original edition by Macmillan. This is the Barnes & Noble edition. And the reason why I bought this is because this book has a very nice secret. It is signed. It's signed by John himself. It says right here, signed by the author, aboard one of Cunard's two great ocean liners, Queen Elizabeth II and Queen Mary II, summer 2005. And it says to Tom, and I can't read that part, who crossed with the author on his great ship, Bon Voyage, and I think it says chap, John Maxtone-Graham. He signed it. This book is signed. And I had a friend of mine who knew John, Mr. Maxtone-Graham, really well, and I sent these pictures of this, and he authenticated to me. Mr. Maxtone-Graham did sign this book. And I just absolutely love it. I'm just like, yeah, fuck. Holy shit, fuck. I can't believe it. I mean, holding this book in my hands, bring me a little bit closer to my favorite author, because I may not get to meet him, but I've got something in my hands that he had in his hand, something he signed, something he had handled and had, you know, done for someone. And I wish I could have met him, but this means a lot. This really means a lot. So there you have it, guys. I mean, that's my tribute to my favorite author. If you if you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comment section below. I'll get back with you. And as always, if you're new to the channel and you like what I'm doing, hit that subscribe button, hit the notification bell. Become part of the Commoner's crew and never miss another fucking video again. And until next time, this is Commoner Urban, saying have smooth seas and clear skies. Happy sailing with you. God bless all of you. Stay happy, stay healthy, stay safe, and just be yourselves. And also, to the great, late great John Maxtone-Graham, God bless you, sir. I hope you're with Jesus, because you're absolutely a godsend to this world and a godsend to the ocean liner community. God bless you, sir.